like a... Good morning.
Rock here.
Nancy here.
Do 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 in the house.
It's like a, I don't know, it feels like a kumbaya song around the, dancing around the fire there.
Yeah, it can be.
Yeah, we're at this point in our morning show there. We're sitting around the campfire and we're holding hands and we're singing kumbaya. Love the one you're with.
Love the one you're with.
Cheers, everybody.
Cheers.
Good morning, Naomi.
Good morning. Whoa, comb your hair. Brush your hair or whatever.
Wait for us for breakfast. Anyway.
That's good.
I took a chance.
You put some protein powder.
I put the protein powder in there.
I can taste it.
It's good. It's not bad, actually. No. Okay, cool. Right on. Because I'm like, well, we can't keep having two smoothies in the morning. In one morning, it's enough we have one.
I'm smoothied out.
No kidding. But it's good.
This one's super good.
This one's forgiving. So the hemp protein powder unsweetened goes well with my orange smoothie. FYI, if you guys want to do that. So how's everybody doing?
It's Thursday.
Thursday. I'm like, what day is it today? Groundhog
sunny,
day, everybody. Groundhog day.
Cloudy. It's doing well.
It's a little warm, but I'm not complaining.
A little warm.
I'm totally not complaining.
If I could unzip my skin off my body, I would.
Really?
It's very warm.
Oh, okay. So today we're really focusing. Well, actually, first thing is this week we're really focusing on love and connection.
Yeah.
Get it in any way, shape, or form.
Yep.
In person, outside. You know what I mean? You don't want to totally break the rules.
Ugh.
But you can bend them a little bit. You can go outside with a friend and go for a nice walk or.
Do you know when the lockdowns stop?
Play spike ball.
I'll tell you when the lockdowns will stop. When we all decide that. We don't do them anymore.
I think we're at that breaking point, though.
And everybody decides.
I think a lot of us are like, that's enough.
We're keeping the stores open, and we're going to start meeting people. When everybody decides that we're going to do that,
right?
Then the lockdowns will stop.
Right.
Because they can't arrest everybody.
No, true enough.
Just saying.
Yeah, so I mean, bend the rules a little bit, I would say. Meet with someone.
Yeah.
I mean, it's for your health and well-being.
Come on.
Honestly.
What do you prefer? Being sick and depressed or meeting somebody in, you know, breaking the rules.
Or if you're not comfortable with that, forgive this guy. If you're not comfortable with that, FaceTime.
You could do FaceTime.
Or phone call.
Meet somebody in your parking lot. Meet somebody in a grocery store.
Yeah,
no big deal.
Something. Yeah, good ideas.
No
sure.
big deal. Costco.
But if you
Get
are
a hot
absolutely
dog at Costco.
Against, if you're absolutely against all of that, then love the one you're with inside your home. That's. Making the most of
if you have
you know,
people
this
inside
lockdown.
Your home with you, yeah.
Exactly. Yeah. And I
for
really,
those of you who don't,
I
know,
think you're allowed to have an extra body.
Reach out.
Home. Yeah. Exactly.
Come and visit.
But
no big deal.
The one that you are spending most time with is your family, your loved ones, and it's super easy for you know at times
Simple.
To knock heads or no butt heads, not kids, butt heads, get annoyed with one another.
Yeah.
You know, just,
That's going to happen when you're in confined spaces with somebody. It doesn't matter how much you love them.
Yeah,
eventually, you're
exactly.
just going to say, get out of my space.
That's what you would call a healthy relationship when you butt heads. You don't agree all the time with the other person. And you speak up for yourself. And then you talk it out. And sometimes it'll
you're
be high...
about yourself here?
It'll be high-pitched voice. We'll use some tonage, some language we don't normally want to use. But either way, you're standing up for yourself. And in either party.
Word.
And then you work things out.
Work it
and
out.
Then you make it work somehow. That's how you last 18, 19 years. Right?
That's us.
Totally
happy.
Yeah. Stop.
Come on.
Yeah. But, I mean, ways you can really
help. Share a meal with somebody in your house, with your family.
Yeah. Little tips for you. If you
play board games. You know?
Yeah. Board games, not video games.
Well, you can play video games as a family.
As long as it's interactive and as a family.
Nothing wrong with that.
No, I know. But,
watch a movie.
To really engage as a family. You really want to spend time together as a family.
We watch Home Improvement. We've been watching
the
whole thing from the beginning.
That's our thing. We're in
season three. That's hilarious. Yeah, season
three.
Third
season now?
Hilarious.
Yeah, it's amazing. I love it.
I love that. It's just so funny. It reminds me of my childhood.
Of course, nostalgia.
It's funny.
For sure.
But it's still funny.
Yeah. Yeah, it really, it applies
Well, it kind of it holds up.
It's it holds up, exactly, it's funny.
It's funny. Some of the things are like, but I'm like,
no way, man. It's all like,
quit being a snowflake rock. Don't worry about it.
Would it really?
No.
Okay. Anywho, yeah, just because like the kids are really they're on screens all day long, so I would encourage maybe having a, like sharing a meal together, no phones. Maybe playing board games or
something.
Going outside to the park.
Yeah.
You know, just to
barbecue.
Switch it up a little bit as much as you can.
We gotta focus on maintaining healthy,
level-headed
mental health.
Yeah, for sure.
It's the number one thing that's going to attack us now. That's attacking everybody. I'm feeling it. I'm feeling it. I'm overwhelmed. I got too much stuff to do there, and I got.
Yeah, but you're putting everything that you have to do full of urgency, pressure, and urgency. And I keep telling you, you're gonna burn yourself out. Yes, you got things you got to do, but it does not require full of pressure and urgency. You're putting that on yourself. You need to meditate.
I need to get shit done. Then I'll meditate.
No. You have to meditate along the way because you... I'm feeling you. I'm feeling it's like, oh, he's... Like, you're intense in your brain. Not like...
Well, yeah.
It hasn't outburst yet, but it's intense in there.
That's what happens when I let my A-type personality run free.
Well, hey.
I have to rein him back in.
I like that you're writing it down.
Get in here.
You're strategic. That's good.
It's a struggle because I always told myself, and I always thought about myself, as an A-type personality that was blocked.
Yes.
Because for many years, I was like not lazy, but like I have all these ideas and I never would pursue them.
Yeah.
But ever since I started to pursue my ideas and I've gotten used to doing that,
I'm becoming
addicted to doing more and more and more things. And it's like, there's not enough time.
There is such a thing that you can get addicted to dopamine. Because dopamine is essentially like when you're reaching a goal, it makes you really feel good.
Yeah.
A lot of times people get addicted to that because it makes them feel good. So they want to hit it all day, every day. But like
you gotta find balance.
There is a cost to that, so you gotta find that balance and nourish your well-being. Go for a nice walk, meditate.
This is how tired I am. I'll tell you how tired I am. I had a dream last night.
Oh boy.
That I was boxing. Okay? I was in a boxing match. Now, I was supposed to enter a tournament. They wouldn't let me enter the tournament because I didn't have enough professional fights under my belt. I had to fight 7 matches in a row. And I remember this vividly in my head. I fought 7 people last night in my dreams, and I was tired. I woke up tired. I was like, screw the run. I just fought 7 people in my dreams. I'm sweating. I'm short of breath.
Yeah, well, it's a combination of watching Rambo last night, and you're going through changes in your life.
Oh, so Rambo.
Yeah.
I won all the matches, in case you guys want to know.
Of course.
I always win in my dreams. I never lose.
There you go.
And as I'm dreaming
metaphor
this dream,
for life, right?
I remember dreaming it. I remember saying to myself, this is your dream. You're gonna win. Just hit him real hard.
Yeah.
Anyways.
So.
I boxed a marathon last night in my dreams.
Love the one you're with. Make the most of it.
Yeah.
Number 2.
Rest.
Make time for yourself. Meditate. Rest.
Take care of your
nature walk.
What's in the cranium?
Don't make everything you got to do full of pressure and urgency.
Yeah.
It's really maybe about like maybe 50% of what you need to do that's full of pressure and urgency.
Yeah, yeah.
Prioritize your day so you don't feel overwhelmed.
Yeah.
Stay away from the news.
100%.
You gotta stay away from like what
stop
you expose.
Stop watching
you,
that
you
garbage.
Become
it's
what
filth.
You're with.
Filth.
And what you expose yourself to.
Filth.
So be mindful of that.
Be mindful.
And reach out to someone. That's outside of your circle.
It's important.
Your household.
That's important. We want you guys to consider filling your brain full of
loving connection.
Feel good stuff.
Feels. Yeah, exactly.
You know, lovey-dovey connection. High fives. Remember when we used to shake hands? Remember that?
Remember when we used to hug?
Oh, man.
It's so funny because it's like...
Wow.
It's like, I love using that saying from Elf, the movie. Oh, wait, I forgot to give you a hug.
Yeah, every time you leave somebody, I forgot to give you a hug.
Anywho, we're going to leave you guys with that.
Yeah,
have yourselves a great Thursday.
We'll see
you guys tomorrow morning at 10:15.
Questions and answers.
Yes,
tomorrow.
And
we
this afternoon, come in and join me for my health coaching session at 3 o'clock.
As always,
we love you. We're thinking about you.
Cold showers,
see you soon.
Fruits, vegetables.
Cheers.
Come on.